What's up, everyone? I'm Kashia, and today is the day I bring you along on my journey. So stay tuned. Hey.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And flex OD, your sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Hey. You got it, girl, you got it. Yeah. Pretty little thing, you got a bag and now you wildin'. You just took it off the line, no mileage.
So, for my first video, I want to introduce myself and talk a little bit about what I do, why I'm starting this YouTube channel, and what my journey shall consist of. Also, I want to talk about why I chose the path that I did. First, I am 24 years old with a bachelor's degree in psychology. I currently work on a medical surgery unit as a PCA, or a patient care associate, and I am currently preparing to go to nursing school. In another video, I want to discuss what the duties of a PCA consist of and the role of a PCA in a hospital and why you should get this kind of job if you're in nursing school or plan on going to nursing school, and just some other tips and things like that. But before we get into my journey and why I chose the path that I've chosen, I want to talk about why I started this channel. So I started this channel because for people like me who have a different journey or a different path, I mean, everybody's journey is their own journey, but I just really want to uplift people and just like let them know that you can keep going no matter what path you take. Everybody's, like I said, everybody's journey is different, so don't compare yourself to others. And really, the channel is just to uplift people, and I get a joy out of just like seeing people say to me like, oh my gosh, like I want to go to nursing school too, and what do you do at your job, and should I get a job like this before I start nursing school, and what, like, just, you know, like, I just like to uplift people and just let them know that you can keep going and keep pushing. And most of all, I want to just share the knowledge that I know and like the mistakes that I've made. Anybody just starting from the bottom, I want to share that with them so they don't make the same mistakes. Okay, so I do want to talk about my approach to nursing school. Yes, I do have a bachelor's degree in psychology. I already have a bachelor's degree. So some people might say, well, you have a bachelor's degree. Oh, you're going to go to an accelerated program, right? An accelerated nursing program, right? Or, yeah, that's the first thing people think. You have a bachelor's degree, so it would be smart or the best idea to go to an ABSN program, accelerated BSN program, which I'll talk about that too. But No, wrong. I am not going to an accelerated BSN program. Actually, I am going to an ADN program. What? Yes, I'm just gonna explain why I'm going to an ADN program. And for those of you who don't know, an ADN program is your associate's degree in nursing. So I will still be an RN, but I won't have my BSN just yet. So yes, I'm going to get my associate's degree in nursing. I'm going to be as real as I can be with y'all. I did not have good luck getting into an ABSN program. No, I didn't. The reasons why I didn't have luck getting to it. Okay, let's back this up. I only applied to 2 ABSN programs. That's it. Only 2. I know I should apply to. You should always apply to like 6 programs. Like, honestly, you should apply to as many as you can. If you meet the requirements, apply to it. But I only applied to 2. I was taking classes after classes after classes after classes. But I just realized that I just gotta be logical about it, honestly. I just gotta be logical about it. Like, I'm 24. I put a lot of money into school. A lot of money into school. So for me, it was not logical. For like certain schools, they're like, oh, you have to take genetics or ethics or things like that. And I'm just tired of putting money into school. So even though it'll be worth it, yes, but. So I applied to 2 schools in Philadelphia. They're very, very competitive. I just I just wasn't competitive enough. I mean, granted, yes, I have the hands-on experience, and my prerequisite GPA was A1, okay? I had a good prereq GPA. My science GPA, which is also my prereq GPA, was up there, like, is up there. So, but unfortunately, that's not the only thing that they look at when you're trying to apply to an ABSN program. They're looking at your overall undergraduate GPA and all of the credit hours that you've completed for your undergraduate and plus your GPA. So those gotta match up. I am a firm believer in everything happens for a reason. So I applied to these two programs, and after doing my research, I just believe that this program was not for me. It might sound crazy, but yes, I just didn't feel like it was for me. Like, of course it sounds good, like, oh, I have a bachelor's degree and it'll only take me 1 year to get my BSN in an ABSN program, but no, I just don't feel like it was for me. And after doing my research on the program, I'm kind of glad I didn't like follow through, because I could have applied to like more programs. So I'm gonna talk about why I believe I did not get accepted into these programs. And I'm gonna be real. Like I said, I'm gonna try to be as transparent as I can be on this channel, okay? I did not have the most competitive GPA. Like, there it is. I did not have the most competitive GPA. If you are applying to an accelerated Bachelor's of Science in Nursing program, your GPA has to be competitive, like up there, like really up there, because you just gotta think, like, these people are applying from all over the place, and they have like bachelor's degrees. Most people who know what they're going for after they, once they get their bachelor's degree, like, they have their bachelor's degree in health science, and so they're really, really working towards this program. Me, on the other hand, was a little different. I didn't know what I wanted to do for my undergraduate. Like, me getting a bachelor's in psychology, I just know that that's something that I can fall back on. Like, I can always further my education and go with psychology, but I didn't know what I wanted to do. And like, at that point, I'm just like, I just want my degree. Like, and I really did believe, I'm just like, oh, it's a lot I can do in psychology. I can get my master's, I can get my PhD, blah, blah, blah. But then it's like, it just depends. Everybody is different. Everybody is different. It just all depends. You never really know why you got denied from a school, or why you weren't as competitive as the next person. You never know. So keep trying. If you apply, just keep trying. If your heart is set on this, keep trying. Not to really make excuses or anything, but like, I had a kind of a rough undergraduate experience. Like, as far as I had to stop going to school for 2 semesters, not back to back, but like, it would be like, I would go from fall and then spring I had to stop, and then I would go back in fall, and then spring I had to stop. Like, it was like that. But it wasn't my choice. It wasn't my choice to stop going for a semester. If it was up to me, I would have kept going throughout the whole semester. But life happens. Life happens. And it's not an excuse at all, but life happens. And again, on top of me not wanting to know what I wanted to do, like, I always knew that I wanted to be in the healthcare field, but I didn't know exactly what I wanted to do. So I feel like if I knew what I wanted to do, like, if I knew, oh, I want to go to accelerated program, I would have applied myself a lot more. But I really didn't find out about that program until like my senior year of college. So at that point, it's too late. So my senior year, I started taking all of my nursing prereqs. And like I said, my prereq GPA is really good, but that's not the only thing that they look at. So moving on, I did my research on an ADN program, and that's just what fits me best, honestly. The things that I found for the ADN program was, for one, it does not cost as much money as an ABSN program. It does not. And the fact that I have all of my prereqs already, so the sun is trying to come out, so my lighting is changing. But the fact that I have all my prereqs already, I won't be spending as much money even still in the ADN program, because I already completed and paid for these extra classes that are required in the ADN program. So the ADN program is 2 years. And even though I have all of the prereqs required, because some students take their prereqs while they're in the nursing program, but me, I have them all completed. So once I start the program, I'm just gonna be taking like nursing one, nursing two, things like that, like doing my clinicals, things like that. Like I don't have to take like AMP one, AMP two, microbiology, chemistry. Like I've done all of that already. So I wish I can take the classes like all together and make it my own little accelerated program, but I can't because of the way the classes fall each semester. So nursing one is in fall semester, nursing two is in spring semester, nursing three is in fall semester, like so it just goes back and forth like that. But this program does not I keep saying I gotta work on that. But this program does not allow you to take classes in the summer, so that's why I can't take them back to back like that. So once I graduate with my ADN, once I pass the NCLEX, I will be an RN. So I can work in the hospital as an RN. And this is kind of what sold me because I'll be working, so it'll take me 2 years to get my RN degree. And I also did research on a program where once you're an RN, it's a bridge program, so you can get your BSN. And what really sold me on this is the BSN program is only 3 semesters. So I'll be working as an RN after 2 years, and then in 3 semesters, I'll have my BSN. So nobody's gonna walk up to you and be like, oh, do you have your BSN? Yes, like at my job, they do like these things where you get like bonuses if you have your BSN. So of course, I mean, it's just a lot of perks of having your BSN. And maybe I'll do another video on BSN versus ADN. But really, I'll be working as an RN. I'll be doing the same thing as the next person with their BSN. And I'll be getting my BSN. It's not like my goal is not to get my BSN, because honestly, my goal is to go further. Like I want to be a nurse practitioner. I don't know if I want to be a nurse practitioner, a nurse anesthetist. Why can't I say that? What the heck? Anyway, or I don't know, but I'm like trying to go up. I'm trying to go further. But this is just the baby steps. And another thing is, like in the BSN program, once you got your RN, this program that I researched and it's local, you'll automatically be enrolled into the BSN program. So why not? Like, it's just, I don't know. Like, I kind of made it not a big deal anymore. Like, I was obsessing, like, oh, I have to get my BSN. I already have a bachelor's degree. Some people may be thinking, what are you doing? You're going backwards. Like, you already have your bachelor's degree. Why are you going to get your associate's degree in nursing when you can just get your BSN? All you got to do is take more classes. But listen, I don't have the time or the money to be taking more classes. Like, I've taken so many classes. If I take another class, I'm going to have a mental breakdown, okay? Not saying that it's not for you. It can be for you. Take as many classes as you need. Don't let me just steer you away. This is just for me. This is my journey. Like, I encourage everybody to go to an ABSN program. If it fits you and it works for you and this is your desire, then do it. Go for it. Don't let nobody tell you any different. Do it. Another thing is, like, you have some program like BSN, ABSN programs that require 1 year, or what is it, like 12 months, 11 months you have. You have the 15 month one, you have the 24 month one. So like there's programs that some accelerate program that require 2+ years. So my thing is, I'll be an RN in 2 years and then I'll be working, and then I'll be going back to get my BSN in 3 semesters. So some of y'all are probably thinking, like, girl, you're crazy, like you should be going to get your BSN. And even some nurses that I've talked to about it were like, why are you going to get your associate's degree when you can just go straight to get your BSN? Just keep taking the classes that other programs require. And I'm just like, nope. I mean, like I said, this is my journey. This is why I'm just explaining why I chose this path, just for other people that may be out there that are going through the same thing as me. It just feels good to know that other people are like you, like, you know. So like I said, some may say like I'm taking steps back, but I'm taking one step back to take 10 steps forward, okay? I could just wait around and just keep going, taking classes and applying to schools and just taking more and more classes, but it's annoying and it's a pain and it's a lot of money. So, moral of the story is, don't let anyone discourage you. You do what's best for you. You do what's right for you. This is your journey and nobody else's, okay? What works for you may not work for other people, and that's fine. What works for other people may not work for you, and that's fine. It's not about them. It's not about anybody else. It's about you. So you do what's best for you. If it's going to an ABSN program, you do it. Yes, girl, do that. If it's going to an ADN program and you already have your BSN, do that, okay? If it's going straight from high school to nursing school, do that. Like, it's so many different paths to nursing. If you do the same job as me, talk to people on your unit, talk to other nurses, do your research, and protect your peace. That's all I have for you guys. Stay tuned for my next video and subscribe and like. Also, if you have any questions and I didn't go over anything that you want to know about, just leave a comment down below and I'll try to get back to you. Thanks for watching.